What's up, everybody? It's Julius here. Today, to give you is a review of the shoes, Balenciaga Speed Trainer. I don't know. Give me the sun for just a year. I'll kiss the sky and disappear. I've been staring up at the grayest skies, trying to find myself some luck, but it's running dry. It's like the weather makes it worse. So let's just take a real quick look at the overall shoe. The entire upper of the shoe is made up of what Balenciaga is calling a 3D knit. It does feel curvy. It does feel like a decent knit material. There's only one seam on the entire upper of the shoe, and there's only heel, and even then it's pretty well hidden. So it does feel really nice on foot. It feels like a stretchy knit upper. It's definitely comfortable. So let's take a look at the midsole. The midsole is where it gets interesting. So this being the 2.0 version, the sole is the main difference. The upper remains the same, but this midsole is segmented, and the memory foam is there to be shaped, and it's there for your support, it's for your cushioning, and there is a Balenciaga knit on the lateral side of the toe. It comes in some sort of red printing, possibly a screen print. On the back of the midsole, you got the Balenciaga logo debased into the heel. You got this stretchy ankle collar area, which does help you get your foot into the sneaker, and then as far as the exterior of the upper goes, that pretty much it moving inside the sneaker. There isn't any padding to sneaker, your foot is just right against the light rose 3D knit, which doesn't feel bad. It's pretty elastic and it does have a nice sock-like feel, so it is pretty comfortable. The insole of the shoe comes in black with the Balenciaga logo printed in red on the heel. And moving to the bottom of the shoe, you got this black rubber outsole with the Balenciaga logo debased across the middle foot. Kiss the sky and disappear. I've been staring up at the grayest skies, trying to find myself some luck, but it's running dry. It's like the weather makes it worse than my cloudy mind. I can really use a dose. For sizing, the Balenciaga Speed Trainer I went with a size 41 and it fit big. It was definitely workable like. I could throw on an extra pair of socks and I would be good to go. But if I had the chance to go back and do it again, I probably would have gone with a size 40 instead of a size 41, which would have fit me better. So it does make sense to go down a size just to make sure your foot isn't sliding over the shoe every step that you take. Okay, so let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think about this Balenciaga Speed Trainer. So thank you guys, enjoyed watching this video, and here is my WhatsApp. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.